Alright, welcome back to the last part of the main story of Before the Storm Remastered. Now, I will be doing a little bit of a small review. I decided just to combine it into like one giant video, give my thoughts at the end. I want to apologize for some reason. The game has like the weirdest thing where like the ending cinematics of like what happens after the story is really bad. I mean, I actually went to Reddit a while back just to look at this. It's pretty bad. But I hope you guys do enjoy. I will be putting some of it in there. I don't know what to say besides that. But thank you all for tuning in to this last part. Hope you guys enjoy. And let's begin.
Hello?
Oh, cool. That worked. How was that?
I need to search this office for any communication with Sarah that can help me find her.
Right. Probably something here.
What do we have here?
Oh, wow. It's actually like...
I should check the computer or some of those files laying around.
Oh, I can't look on the...
Okay. Arcadia Bay's least wanted.
Let's see. Police Department. Let's see. Sergeant Alex Keller, Damon Merrick. Assault with a deadly weapon. Oh, wow. Oh, wow. Several times in the head. That is insane. Okay.
James has a file on Frank. I'd love to read this, but I've got to focus on finding Rachel's mom.
I don't think this is a good idea at all.
Best dad? That stuff is all politics anyway.
What?
Hmm.
What was that? Bolt button?
Sweet. A secret key. Now to find the secret lock.
True. Oh, he's just saying thank you. So everyone's becoming more and more, like, nicer. How did you actually come out?
Sheldon. Why do I feel like I've heard that name before?
Known assailants of, Damon Merrick. They work for the guy. You met him at that, concert.
I guess getting your ass kissed comes with the DA territory.
Oh, no. Graffiti. Do we have Tom? Really? Really? That's cute. Don't think we have time for that, but why not?
Even if James is trying to protect Rachel from her mother, this seems like a pretty terrible way to act.
Eski Hart. Whoa. Okay, so who did he send to talk sense into her?
James sure keeps lots of files on people.
Sure does.
Welcome to Shadyville.
Look at me in a box. Oh, a tape recorder. Phone, and it was ringing a while ago.
To know who James is talking to on the secret phone of his. It could be about Sarah.
Okay. You know she attacked me first, right? You should really teach her to behave better. Nothing. I guess you don't need this taken care of anymore.
James is working with Damon Merrick?
Knew it.
This is insane. What were they talking about? Is the girl Damon's talking about Sarah? Whatever is going on, I need to see if Damon knows where Sarah is. But how do I get him to tell me?
Let's not be obvious. Let's say you'll pay.
What do I say?
Let's say I did.
Hope James actually has this evidence. Don't think Damon will tell me where Sarah is, unless I send him a picture.
Oh, that evidence. There we go.
Shit. Which of these is Damon talking about? I could just take a wild guess and see what he says. Or maybe there's some info on the case hanging around the office.
Look at the glove.
If TV has taught me anything, these babies will be swimming in DNA.
Victim Eli Forbin, date 4/12/10, case info 388. Recovered by Officer Ernie Yates. Let me look here real quick. Crime report. Okay, that matches the case number 3888, reporting officer Sergeant Keller, Damon Merrick. So this is the one we're talking about right here. Verbal altercation. Merrick branded a fire poker, hitting the victim several times in the head before fleeing scene. Merrick's gloves were recovered. Okay, so this is definitely it.
If I can figure out how. How do I destroy a glove? Maybe I can burn it somehow.
Do you really want to burn it though, or?
Sarah sent all these letters, and James never gave them to Rachel? It's so messed up.
See, I knew Merrick and the DA were working together. I called that shit in episode 2. There's no way that Sarah, Merrick, Frank, and all these people that are connected to Sarah was not known with the DA. He's the flippin' DA. He obviously knows that. And on top of that, she's keeping Rachel from her. But he's basically hiding.
Sarah in this letter doesn't seem anything at all like the person James told us about last night.
Exactly. That's why I'm 100% sure there's more to the story than just that. Oh, wow.
So, this looks like Sarah stopped cashing the checks James sent her. Guess he forgot to mention that during his story last night.
So, this goes all the way back to December 14, 2009. That was a whole year ago. So she's been stopping the payments for a while now. I think we should burn it. We should try to burn something else.
Oof. Better not touch that again.
No clue, no more. Let's say no more. You've already given him what he wants, now he wants more. What problem?
Damn. I hope James has something here to tell me who Damon's informant is.
Shit.
So I need to find which of Damon's guys has been snitching. I should search around the office to see if there's any info to help me out.
Right. See what the mom says. Chloe, is everything okay? It's fine. Oh.
Arcadia Bay's least wanted.
No one's hit accused. Be smart about this.
Okay, there's no way that Frank is snitching on Damon. But I love learning about his badass loitering charge.
So that's it? Loitering?
This is that freak from the mill. Wonder what Damon would think of his very cooperative comment.
Void income ship leader.
I agree to aid the courts on future cases. That could be seen as a little snitchy.
Read Glenn Gerald Scott. So he's the snitch then. Gerald Scott.
Arcadia Bay's least wanted.
I don't have to tell him the truth. I can actually lie. Maybe.
Okay. If I'm going to accuse one of these guys, I'd better be sure I'm right.
Let's see.
Guess this explains why Mr. Amber knows so much about Frank.
Makes sense.
Could this douchebag be the snitch Damon's talking about? This is that asshole who was selling Firewalk shirts. This guy let me into the mill. Cool dude.
Him?
Payment? Fuck.
Damn it.
Here's hoping James already has Damon's money. But where would it be?
Sawdust.
I wonder if this has anything to do with Damon's stash.
Really? What?
Holy shit. Fuck, that's Sarah. And she's at the mill. What is he doing to her?
Nothing good. Let her go, yeah. Damn it.
Holy shit. Does James even know what he's doing?
Do you know what you're doing?
I still have time. Damon's waiting for his money, right? He wouldn't do anything to her. Yet. Fuck. I need to get there fast.
Chloe?
What? Who's that?
Elliot?
Hey.
Elliot? What are you doing here?
What are you doing here? This is Rachel's house, right?
Did he really just follow me here?
This doesn't feel right. I mean, I get he likes her, but that's still a little creepy.
I can't really talk about it. Rachel needs my help.
I'm sure she does. I'm more concerned about you.
I'm fine. You're the one acting crazy. You shouldn't be here.
Chloe. What is...
Elliot, put that down. You have no idea what you're dealing with.
And you do? Chloe, God, what have you gotten yourself into?
You wouldn't understand.
Give me a chance. What the hell are you doing?
It's Rachel's mother. It's serious. Yeah, to say it's serious, I don't want to get him involved.
I can't tell you, but obviously this is pretty serious shit. That's why I need to leave right now.
You mean serious for Rachel, right? But you're the one putting yourself in danger again. I'm so sick of you not seeing who Rachel really is. When will you realize what she's doing to you?
Elliot, just take a step back.
No! You need to listen to me. What has your relationship with her gotten you?
You don't know what you're talking about.
First night you hang out, what happens? You end up in a fight.
She saved me. Well,
you don't know what you're talking about. Rachel saved my ass.
I'm sure that's how it seemed to you.
Stop suggesting that she's somehow bad
for... The next day she convinces you to skip school. Magically, she barely gets in trouble. And you get expelled.
She did defend me, but he is sort of making sense. Sort of.
Rachel was there for me. She did everything she could to protect me.
I guess it wasn't enough, huh?
You don't understand. You weren't there.
Was she protecting you when she made you take part in a play you didn't want to be in?
God, look. I'm sorry I ditched you for the play, but...
This isn't about that.
Seriously, man. You need to shut the fuck up before...
I've been quiet long enough. Look, Rachel is an amazing actress. And I don't mean on stage. She's fake. You're real. And I hate to see her manipulate you like this.
Elliot. I promise. No one is manipulating me.
No? Just look where you are now. A high school dropout. Hanging out with criminals and breaking into houses. It's crazy. It just as easily could have been you in that hospital today. If that ever happened...
I won't say stalker much, but he is sort of, kind of... I mean, it is very circumstantial, but... And then it goes back to that dream that she keeps having about the crow. And how fire's beauty... And it blinds. It's all consuming. So it's a little concerning that he's kind of making sense.
Look, I hear you. I appreciate the concern.
I don't think you do.
Elliot.
I'm the one who cares about you, Chloe. Me, not Rachel. It's time you saw the truth.
What does that mean?
It means you're going to stop thinking about Rachel and pay attention to me now, for once.
Okay, that's extraordinarily possessive and a little toxic. I was kind of with him for a while, but then he just kind of blew straight past toward the really weak male vibe. I mean, if he was just saying, look, I'm your friend, this doesn't make sense. This is going down a very bad road for you. You have to stop. And maybe.
Elliot, please. I know you're upset, but...
I'm not upset!
Yes, you are.
I'm trying to help you.
Call for help.
Elliot's gone full-blown crazy. I need to get the police to come without tipping him off.
Who was there for you? When Max left? When your dad died? No one else gave a shit about you except for me.
That's not true.
You have a lot to talk about. And I don't care how long it takes. We're not leaving until you see that I'm right.
Really? Oh no. 911,
what's your emergency?
All right, Elliot. You want to talk so bad? Let's talk.
Oh, well, I can't even miss one time. Are you serious?
What's really going on here? You can tell me.
here's what's going on. We're at the DA's house, and we should probably leave before he comes back.
Don't worry. With Rachel in the hospital, James isn't coming anytime soon. I'm talking about your situation. Rachel is dangerous. You need to realize that.
Life's at risk. I feel threatened.
You're right, Elliot. I didn't want to admit it before, but it's true. My life is at great risk.
Thank you, Chloe. All I want is to help you. I'm glad you can finally see that.
You're right. I do need help. I need help immediately.
Hey, it's okay. I'm not going anywhere.
I feel trapped. Boxed in. I desperately want to leave this situation.
It takes a lot of guts to tell me all this. And I want you to know that I will always be there for you. No matter what.
Yeah, creepy. Really, really creepy.
It's the police.
Okay, don't panic. I'm sure they'll just want to ask us why we're here.
What do we do?
I'll talk to them. There's nothing to be concerned about.
Thank you, Elliot. You're a great friend.
Idiot. Well, that is not great. He seemed all sensible at first, but he just got really creepy. That was a huge, like, personality shift. It's finally out, but it took out everything.
So much destruction. All because Rachel got angry at her dad, who's been lying to her all her life, and he's still lying.
Hey, being a dad's tough.
That doesn't justify what he's done.
I'm just saying, I'd probably do anything to keep you safe.
Hey, Dad?
Yeah?
Did you ever lie to me? I don't mean telling me that ashtray I made for Mom wasn't a piece of crap. I mean, like, really lied about something that might hurt me to know.
What do you think?
Everybody lies, just like the train said.
I suppose everyone lies about big things. I mean, the stuff Mom doesn't know about me. So you probably lied too.
Would you love me less?
Of course not.
You sound pretty sure, sweetheart. You were pretty sure Mom would never fall in love with someone like David, too. Are you really ready to hear the answer to your question?
The graphical problems are ruining the moment. I don't really need to know. It's...
You know what, Dad? Never mind. I don't need to know.
Everyone lies. Sometimes...
What way? That I'll always be the perfect dad?
How many people get to say that? No word. My ride, my tunes. Seriously going in to face Damon Merrick? All for Rachel? Am I crazy?
Hella crazy.
I'm glad you're here, Dad.
You don't want me to go?
No. I like the company. Besides, you don't want to miss this. Things are about to get real.
I did not see this going well at all. Not at all.
Shit. Is that blood? Frank! Shit, this is bad. I'll get you help, Frank. But first, I've gotta help Rachel's mom.
Well, obviously Frank didn't die.
Where the hell is Sarah? Glad to see the bone made it. No more beer. No more time. I've got to keep moving.
You're tagging this now?
Don't tell me what to do.
Okay, I'm about to say, this doesn't seem like a good optional graffiti moment.
Frank's couch is toast.
We can't go up the stairs, obviously. Can't go there.
No.
Shh. Everything's going to be just fine. Just a little longer, and all your troubles are going bye-bye.
What the fuck?
I just want to meet my daughter. Can't you understand why does
he... Your daughter? Jesus. So that's what he's worried about. Can't let the public know. The mother of his daughter is some junkie.
I just want to see her. You don't have to...
Shut up. James Amber wants you out of the picture, so that's what's going to happen.
This is so messed up.
After all, no one believes a junkie.
No.
He said you've been sober a year. Respect. It's hard to kick this shit.
You can do this. Damon.
What the hell are you doing here?
I've got your money right here. The money James owes you.
How the fuck do you...
Run!
No one has to know. Just let her go, and I won't say...
Talking's over.
Leave her alone!
Shut up. What the fuck? You boosted the DA's shit? Got my money? Burned the evidence? All that?
I'm just trying to help.
Get away from her!
I said shut the fuck up!
No!
Go to your fucking happy place.
Run.
Let this be a lesson, kid. Make good life choices, or you'll end up like her. Now, what do I do with...
Damon! What did you do?
I fucked you up good, didn't I? Guess you really don't know when to quit. Glad to see you back on your feet.
Chloe.
Frank.
You don't really want to do this again, do you? Okay. Then I don't want to do this again. Come on, man. Fuck you.
Ooh!
Sarah. Rachel. Your daughter. She... Chloe Price.
You know my... She knows her? How?
You know who I am?
I saw you in the play. You were funny.
Thanks.
Sit.
Sarah. Are you okay?
We need to talk about what happened.
I am so, so sorry for...
Rachel can never know.
What exactly can't Rachel know?
What James did. Hiring that thug. Shooting me up with...
He's a piece of shit. And I promise that
Rachel can never know.
Yeah, I really don't understand. I mean, I get that he's a more stable parent. But this shit... I mean, people could have just as easily died. He covered up evidence. I mean, this has probably happened before. And here's the thing, the DA worked with Damon Merrick way before all this shit happened. Because he's the one that sent Merrick to him, to her. So, I don't understand.
Tell me why. Doesn't she deserve to know what her father did?
No. Rachel deserves a loving father. A father who cares for her.
James is a liar.
James is a desperate man who loves his daughter. And she loves him. Tell her what happened here, and you'll take that away from her. Forever.
The truth matters, man. You cannot do that. I understand that between, like, two consenting adults, if it doesn't work out, fine, but this was just, he just kept making bad decisions left and right. Damon Merrick would have never stabbed his daughter or got involved with any of this if he never would have involved him in that, in his family's troubles. This, I mean, if he gets away with this, he's gonna do it again.
Don't you think the truth matters more?
The truth? What's so great about the truth, Chloe?
Why are you saying all this?
Because James is right. He's taken something from me that I might not ever get back. But he's right. I'm broken.
Everybody's broken, Sarah.
Oh? Does everybody abandon their own child for 15 years? Does everybody take money to stay away?
You're here now. That's what matters.
What do you know?
I know Rachel needs you. I know loss. I lost my father 2 years ago.
How?
Car accident. He was picking up my mother from the grocery store, and a truck ran a red light, and that was it.
I'm sorry. You don't know what this is to me. Every pain. Every fear. Gone. No more sadness. No more grief. Why would anyone not want to feel that way? Ever.
Because it makes you inhuman. You need those things to survive. You need fear. You need hatred, anger. You need hope. This is what makes us humans. It comes a part of it. You quit for a year. You did it. You can do it again.
I read your letter to James. You beat this before. You can beat it again.
No. I can't.
I recognize I might not know what the fuck I'm talking about here, but I wish you could know how amazing Rachel is.
I know.
She's fearless. She's brilliant and talented. And she feels so much. She's so strong.
She's had a good life. Raised in a loving home, given opportunities I could never give her.
At least talk to her. She's felt like something's been missing her whole life. She told me so. That something was you.
She didn't miss anything.
She has a perfect family.
I used to think my dad was perfect. But now I realize he was probably just as messed up as everyone. And it doesn't make me love him any less.
That's a nice thought. What Rachel needs, though, is not to have her father taken away from her.
He doesn't deserve...
It's not about James. It's not about me, and it's not about you. It's about Rachel. Tell her what James did, and you'll be killing him for her. You understand that, don't you? You lost your father. Do you really want to put Rachel through that?
She lost her father through loss. She'd be sacrificing her father in that for good reasons. You cannot give people chances like this. It's just bad.
The worst mistake you ever made was giving Rachel up. That's what you said in your letter to her.
You read that.
You don't have to make the same mistake twice.
Nothing can change the mistakes I made. I'll never get to be Rachel's mother. Not really. But there's one thing I can still do for her. The only thing I can do. Let me give her the father she deserves. The one who raised her, protected her. The one who loves her more than anything. You can do whatever you want, Chloe. You have the power. What you have to decide is whether you're going to protect Rachel or cause her even more hurt. So please, tell her I was never here. Let her have what peace she can without me.
Wait! Don't go, Sarah.
I'm done here. Goodbye, Chloe.
What happened with Damon and Frank? They just leave?
Hello?
Hi, Chloe. Rachel's just fallen asleep.
I know she'll be thrilled to see you when she wakes up. Maybe come back a little later?
Hey.
Go back to sleep, kiddo. You need your rest.
Can I talk to Chloe? Alone? For a minute?
Okay, sweetie. We'll be right outside.
How are you feeling?
Like I got stabbed. Doc says there'll be a sick scar. Maybe a tattoo is in order.
Fuck yeah.
We never actually escaped, did we? We've got time. All the time in the world. So, how did everything go? Rachel, I've got to tell you something.
I'm going to be honest with you. I'm going to tell her everything. I'm not the kind of person that would lie. I'm sorry. Too much has happened. Too many people got hurt because of this whole situation. Herself, Rachel, burned down and caused massive damage. Who knows how many people could have been affected or died because of this. Then on top of everything else, her father, a district attorney, hired a drug dealer, a violent one, to persuade, I use those in quotation marks, to legitimately scare off. His own daughter got stabbed because of it. That would have never happened if Frank or if Merrick wasn't involved. It's amazing to me that anyone would actually say that we need to protect her from the truth, because the truth, unfortunately, needs to come out. He needs to be fired. He needs to be put on trial. That whole thing was just bad. Alright, so that is the end of the game. Gotta say, it was a beautiful experience, I will say that. I will say this though, some of the graphics, I won't put in the ending, whatchamacallit, because I want to be 100% honest with you, it's really bad. I don't know what's going on with this remake. I don't know if it's for the Series S or for, I don't know. Maybe I should have played this on PC, but I want to try to capture card out a little bit more on my channel. On my other games, it plays pretty fun. I have to touch up a little bit of the HDR content. Maybe a bit dark with little black splotches every once in a while. I'll change it, or the colors a little bit more increased or needs to be decreased depending on the scene. But for the most part, it was a pretty good experience, I will say overall. A lot of people say that this is the weakest episode in the series because it was a lot of, subplots that are going on. At the end of the day, I still think it was a great experience, and I think it really opens up more of the world into the actual main Life Strange series. At least the first part, anyway. I can't wait to play the second one. I think I played maybe halfway into the second episode of Life is Strange 2, then I just stopped. Not enough for me to actually remember anything, but I will say this though. I'm excited to play it. It might take a little while because I got a lot of other series I want to actually come out and focus on. But for the most part, I'm totally open to doing the entirety the Life is Strange series because it's such a great series. While this one didn't focus on a supernatural element like most of the other games, at the very least, it was a great experience, and Chloe was such a great character, in my opinion. Really good, well-written, designed. You could actually see the pain and suffering through the dreams, which was like the most confusing element to me. The dreams are, in my opinion, I don't really know. I kept thinking that this father was telling her that, like, you know, Rachel comparing her to fire, being beautiful but blind, and saying how their relationship might not be very stable. Maybe because maybe Chloe has so much dependency on her. But Chloe opened up to a whole bunch of other people in the series, not just Rachel, Drew, Mikey, even Steph. It seems like she has a few more options for friends now. She's a lot more open now. As for the ending choice, I feel like I made the right decision. There's no way in hell I would let her stay with her father, because that would... I'm sorry, it's just a really bad decision, in my opinion. Anyone who can do something like that with the power they have is corrupt, and corruption just doesn't just sit in one place, it spreads. But without further ado, I'm gonna go ahead and let you see the ending scene. It is quite sad. I apologize for that, but we all knew it was coming. So without further ado, thank you all for tuning into this series. Be on the lookout for Life is Strange Part 2. Or 2. Sorry, not Part 2, but actual 2. But thank you all for tuning in. Thank you for being a part of my channel. I really appreciate the, you know, support. This is a really small channel, but I love doing these Let's Plays, and they're really cool. Showcases that not every game has to be a shooter or an RPG. It can be just a relaxing, good, well-built story. But without further ado, I'm going to see you guys later. I want you guys to have a great day. Be sure to leave me a comment or a like of how I can do better. And subscribe if you haven't. But without further ado, I'll see you guys next time. Peace.